Hello everyone, my name is Chetan Gowda RK, and in this video I'm going to discuss about the design and detailing of the circular water tanks. So before going into the design of the analysis and the design of the circular water tanks, so first I will discuss about the some basic concepts and also some important things about the water tanks. So you all know that the water tanks are the storage tanks or the these are the storage tanks which are built for the storage purpose, that is the storage of any kind of the fluid. Like water, liquid petroleum and also the petroleum products or any similar liquids. So such kind of storage tanks and next we'll look into the classification of the water tank. So here the classification of the water tank that can be made based on two different conditions. One is based on its shape and based on its position. So based on the shape we have two types. One is a circular shape, another one is a rectangular shape. Then based on the position we have three types. One is the resting on the ground, then the next one is elevated or overhead tank, and then the next one is a underground. And again here in the under the type of the water tank which is resting over the ground, again it has three subtypes. One is a flexible or a free base, then next one is a hinged base, and next one is a fixed base. Here this classification has been made based on the connectivity between the sidewall of the tank and then base slab. So this is the sidewall and this portion is base slab. So depending on the connectivity between the sidewall and the base slab, so the water tanks which are resting over the ground, that has been classified into the flexible base or a rigid flexible or a free base, hinged base and fixed base. So we'll discuss these things one by one. So first we'll take classification based on the shape. So we all know that classification based on the shape, it might be a circular one or a rectangular one. So normally the selection of these type of tanks, it depends on the size of the tank, or indirectly I can say that it depends on the storage capacity. So usually if the storage capacity is more or the size of the tank is more, in such cases it is preferable to go for a water tanks which is of a circular shape, and for the small sizes a rectangular tanks are more preferable. Then depending on the position, so we have three types. One is resting on the ground, the next one is a elevated or a overhead, and the next one is a underground. So here the selection of a suitable type of the tank based on the position, that depends on the ground profile for the of the area for which water needs to be supplied. Like for example, say this is a place, or imagine you have a township somewhere here, okay, and then if this particular township, okay, if this lies in a valley, and then here you have some elevated place. Okay, so this is a elevated ground. Okay, so in this kind of situation, there is no need to go for the elevated or overrun tank, because even if we make the water tanks either resting over the ground or a underground water tank, or partially resting and partially underground, so you can supply the water through the gravity, because the township or a place where you want to supply the water, or where you want to supply the any fluid, if it lies at the low lying area compared to the location of the tank, so then in such situations we can go for the water tanks which is resting over the ground. And then normally we'll go for the storage tanks which are resting over the ground to store the fluid, to store the petroleum products, that is liquid petroleum products or liquid petroleum, to store these kind of fluids or any chemicals. So in such situations we can go for the storage tanks which are resting over the ground. Then when it comes to the water tanks, when it is preferable to go for the resting over the ground, resting on the ground is when the township or a place where you want to supply the water, that located at the low-lying area, and the water tank is planned to construct at the high elevated plane. So in such situations, the water tanks resting over the ground is preferable. Resting over the ground or the underground, so anything is preferable. Then, so when you require a elevated or a overhead tank is, suppose if you have a complete flat terrain, or if the profile is somewhere like this, and if you want to plan to build a water tank, and the where you want to supply the water if it is not possible to supply the water through the gravity, and in order to create a enough amount of the head to make the water to flow to the required place, we need to construct the elevated or a overhead tank. So depending on the ground profile where you want to supply the water, you need to select the suitable type of the tank based on its position. And then the next classification is a sub-classification of the water tanks which are resting on the ground. So one is a flexible or a free base, the next one is a hinged base, the next is a fixed base. So as I mentioned, these classification that has been made depending on the connectivity between the tank wall or a side wall with the base slab. Suppose if it is a flexible or a free base, then there won't be any connectivity between the tank wall and the base slab. No connectivity in the sense there is no continuity in the reinforcement, or there is no continuity in the concrete portion. Here these two parts, that is a tank wall and the base slab, that has been separated by a bearing pad. So usually it will be of neoprene rubber pads. So this neoprene rubber pads that will be provided at the a bottom of the tank wall, and then so here the gap has to be sealed. This gap needs to be sealed with the sealing compound in order to avoid the leakage of the water. So this is how the fixed or a free base needs to be made. And then in case of a hinge support, then here there will be some connectivity in the reinforcement between the tank wall and the base slab, but here it behaves like a hinge support it behaves like a hinge. That means there won't be any distribution of the moment from the tank wall to the base slab. But when it comes to the fixed base, then there will be a continuity in the reinforcement and the continuity in the concrete portion. Okay, so such kind of a tank walls, we call it as a fixed base tank walls. And in such cases, so there will be a connectivity in the reinforcement. And also in such cases, in such type of the water tanks, that is a fixed water tank, you need to provide a haunch in the inner edge of the tank. So this haunch needs to be provided in order to take care of the additional stresses which may develop at this junction due to the connectivity between the tank wall and the base slab. So this is about the classification of the water tank. So then moving on to the some important things. So in case of a free or a flexible base tank, between the tank and the base slab, the walls are free to slide and expand, and the hoop tension developed in the circular wall that can be calculated easily due to the hydrostatic pressure. However, for a hinge and a fixed base, the coefficients of the moments and the ring tension are compiled in table 12.7 and 12.10 as recommended in 1 IS 3370 part 4. So these coefficients are expressed as a function of the a non-dimensional parameter, that is h square by dt. So these are the important points which we need to remember while doing the analysis of the water tanks. Okay, so before going into the analysis and the design of the water tank, first before going into the analysis and design of the water tank, first we should know the behavior of the circular water tank when it has a free base or a flexible base, and then when it has a fixed base. And also you should know what are the reinforcement that needs to be provided. So first we'll start with I will start with the free base. Or a flexible base. Okay, so when you have a free base or a flexible base, we all know that this is the tank wall and this portion is base slab, and here some rubber bearing will be provided, and this joint will be sealed by water sealing compound. So now you know that when any fluid is stored inside this tank and then this particular tank will be subjected to the hydrostatic pressure. So depending on the height of the, depending on the depth of the water stored in the tank, so it will get the lateral pressure in the form of the water pressure. So since it is of a circular shape and then it is subjected to the uniform pressure, on the complete circumference of the a circle, that develops the hoop tension. Okay, so here in order to take care of this hoop tension, we need to provide the hoop steel or reinforcement. So here I am writing the plan view. Okay, so that hoop steel or a hoop reinforcement that will be provided in the horizontal direction. Okay, so here depending on the size of the tank, so whatever the hoop steel will provide, so either we can provide it on a single face or at the midpoint or a mid section of the wall. Suppose if the size of the tank is more, then this hoop steel that will be provided both at the inner face as well as outer face. So that is the one type of a steel which we need to provide to take care of the hoop tension. Okay, so then along with this we have to provide the reinforcement in the vertical direction in order to provide the support for the hoop steel. So this is about how we need to provide the reinforcement for the circular tank with a flexible base and also its behavior. Then when it comes to the next, when it comes to the fixed base, okay, and before going into the fixed base, so one more important thing I need to tell. So here you know that the magnitude of the water pressure or a hoop tension what we get, okay, so that depends on the height. That means at the top the water pressure will be minimum and then at the bottom water pressure is maximum. Okay, so here while providing the hoop steel for the tank wall, if you provide the reinforcement based on the highest magnitude what you get at the bottom, so then that becomes a that particular design will become uneconomic, because if you provide the same amount of the steel even at the top, so it's a waste of the steel what we are providing here, because that is not required at the top portion, because the magnitude of the water pressure what you will get at the top, it's almost close to zero only. There only the concrete section itself is sufficient to take care of that magnitude of pressure, but we need to provide a some amount of the steel. So in order to make it economical, so what we need to do is we have to divide the tank wall into the segments. So here the division of the segments what we make, again it depends on the, so again it is dependent on the designer choice. So either you can make the division of 1 meter, 0.5 meter like that, then at every interval you need to determine the magnitude of the hoop tension. So for that particular magnitude of the hoop tension, you are supposed to provide the steel. Okay, so that is about the free base or the flexible base. The next, when it comes to the fixed base, so the behavior of the fixed base, it's almost similar to the free base only, but the difference where we get is, see here, we know that in case of the fixed base, there will be a continuity in the reinforcement, and that means whenever this subjected to the water pressure, so this behaves like a single unit. Okay, so whatever the moment that will develop at this junction due to the lateral pressure or a water pressure, so that will be get transferred to the base slab also, because it is having a continuity in the section. So when it comes to the reaction forces, what you will get in this in case of a fixed base is, one is the hoop tension and another one is a bending moment at base due to cantilever action. Okay, so normally as I explained, normally we know that how the hoop tension will create in case of a circular water tank. So you know that because of its shape, when it is subjected to the uniform pressure all around, then that leads to the formation of the hoop tension, right? Then since there is a continuity in the section, in this case the tank wall, it behaves like a cantilever portion. So we know the definition of the cantilever, that means its one end will be fixed and the other end will be free. So in the same way, the tank wall will behave when it is subjected to the lateral water pressure. So when it is subjected to the lateral water pressure, so since it has a fixity at the bottom, so it will be having a cantilever action. So in case of a fixed base water tank, due to the water pressure, you will get the two reaction forces. One is a hoop tension, another one is the bending moment. So now when it comes to the reinforcement, here the reinforcement needs to be provided for both the reaction forces. So we know that the reinforcement for the hoop tension, it will be provided in a circular manner in the horizontal direction, and the vertical reinforcement, so what we provide, the vertical reinforcement, it is based on the cantilever action. Okay, so the hoop steel or horizontal reinforcement, that is dependent on the hoop tension, and then the vertical reinforcement in case of a fixed base, that is dependent on the magnitude of bending moment due to the cantilever action. So that is about the behavior of the circular and now that is about the behavior of the circular water tank with the flexible base and then rigid base. Then next we'll take up the problem on the design of the circular water tank. So here first I will read out the given data for which we are supposed to do the design of the circular water tank. So here we need to design a circular tank with a flexible base for capacity 5 lakh liters, and then the depth of the water is given as 4 meter and the freeboard is given as 200 mm. And here we need to use M20 grade of concrete and the grade 1 mild steel, and the permissible direct tensile stresses in concrete that needs to be taken as 1.2 Newton per mm square, and the permissible stress in steel in direct tension that needs to be taken as 100 Newton per mm square. Then after that we need to sketch the details of the reinforcement. Okay, so for this data we need to design the water tank. So first we'll note out the all the given data. So first thing what they have given is the capacity of the tank, it's of 5 lakh liters. Then the depth of the water is 4 meter and the freeboard is 200 mm. And we have supposed to use the M20 grade of concrete and the grade 1 steel. Then the permissible stresses which are given in the data are the direct tensile stress in concrete that is equal to 1.2 Newton per mm square, and the tensile stress in steel which is equal to 100 Newton per mm square, and the modular ratio M that is equal to 13. Then first we'll fix up the dimension for the tank. So here the dimension of the tank, it is dependent on the storage capacity. So here height of the tank is given. Okay, so to only unknown what we are supposed to find is the required diameter of the tank. So we all know that to find the diameter of the tank, that can be determined by using the relation, you know that volume is equals to total volume the tank that is equal to storage capacity. Okay, so we know the volume of the circular shaped we know the expression for the to determine the volume of any circular shaped object, so which is equal to the cross section area multiplied by height. The cross section area for the circular shaped object that is equal to pi d square by 4, that multiplied by height. Here height of the tank that is given as 4 meter. Then here the capacity of the tank is given as 5 lakh liters. So here first we need to convert liters to the meter cube. To convert liters to meter cube we need to multiply it by 10 power minus 3. So if we work it out, we'll get the required diameter to store the 5 lakh liters of the water. If the height of the tank is 4 meter, then the diameter what we are supposed to provide is 12.7 6 meters. So after finding the diameter, after determining the diameter of the a tank to store the 5 lakh liters of the water, then we will find the thickness of the tank wall. So here whatever the thickness we are taking now, it's just a trial section. Okay, so this is just a trial section. So when we do the check for this particular thickness, if it is not satisfied, then we need to revise the thickness of the wall. So now the thickness of the side wall that can be obtained using the relation, that is equal to 30 multiplied by h plus 50. So this is a relation what we have to find the a trial thickness of the tank walls. So here where h is the height of the tank, where h is the height of the tank in meters. So here the height of the tank, here the value of h that needs to be considered as 4 meter, because up to 4 meter only you will get the water pressure, above which it's a freeboard. So to determine the thickness, we'll consider only the depth of the water when the storage is, when the liquid is full inside the tank. So 30 multiplied by 4 plus 50. So this will be 170 mm. Okay, so here, so whatever the thickness we had taken here, it's just a trial section. So when it's just a trial section, so if this section is not sufficient, then it needs to be revised. So after finding the dimensions of the tank, then we need to determine the hoop tension at a different positions of the at different depths in the water tank. So as I explained while explaining the behavior of a flexible based water tank, so since the water pressure is not uniform throughout the depth, so it will be maximum at the bottom and minimum at the top, even the hoop tension also, hoop tension magnitude also, it will be same. So it will be maximum at the bottom and minimum at the top. So if we just provide a maximum amount of the steel throughout the depth, then that becomes uneconomical design. So in order to make the design economical, in order to provide the only the required amount of the steel, so in order to avoid the unnecessary wastage of the steel, we have to determine the magnitude of the hoop tension by dividing the tank wall into the segments. Okay, so at each sections we need to determine the magnitude of the hoop tension, and then for the respective hoop tension we need to determine the required amount of the steel to take care of that hoop tension. Okay, so first we'll start with the hoop tension from the bottom. Okay, so here the hoop tension at the bottom, that will be treated as a maximum hoop tension, because the water pressure is maximum at the bottom. So we have a relation for the maximum hoop tension, which is equal to WHD divided by 2. So where W is the density of the storage fluid, and H is the height, and D is the diameter that divided by 2. So here you know that W is the density of water. Either you can take 9.808 or you can take it as 10, and H is the depth 4.2, and D is the diameter of the tank. We know it's 12.6 meters. If we divide it by 2, we'll get the maximum hope tension what we get at the bottom. Here it is equal to 246 kilo Newton. So now, in order to determine the amount of the steel which we are supposed to provide to take care of this hope tension, AST is equals to hope tension divided by the permissible stress of the steel under tension. So it's given in the problem that the permissible stress of the steel under tension, it needs to be taken as 100 Newton per, this is equal to 100 Newton per mm square. Okay, so HT is equal to 246 into 10 power 3. So here 10 power 3 had multiple because we are substituting all the values in Newton and mm. So this is 264.6 into 10 power 3 Newton. So that is the magnitude of the hoop tension, that divided by the permissible stress of the steel, that is 100. So if you work it out, we'll get area of steel equal to 2646 mm square for per meter height. Then for this AST, we are supposed to distribute for a 1 meter height from the bottom. So here to distribute the steel, I am assuming we need to assume the certain diameter of the bar. So here I have taken a 20 mm dia bar. So in order to determine the spacing of these bars, you know the relation for that, that is area of the individual bar that I am representing as a small AST and total amount of the steel which we are supposed to provide, that I am representing it as capital AST, that multiplied by 1000. So this is the relation what we have to determine the spacing. So here area of the 20 mm dia bar, that is the cross section area of the 20 mm dia bar, that is equal to 314, and then the total amount of the steel for the per meter height, that is 2646. So multiplied by 1000, we will get the spacing as 118 mm. So here we can provide a 20 mm dia bar at 118 mm, or it can be provided for 110 mm center to center. So this is for the hoop steel at the bottom. Then after obtaining the magnitude of the hoop tension at the bottom, the next thing we need to check whether the thickness what we have provided is safe or not, or through this equation we can determine the required thickness. Through this equation we can determine the required thickness for the wall. Okay, so here in order to determine the required thickness of the wall, we have the relation, that is hoop tension. Hoop tension relation, we know that it's a ratio of WH D by 2, where W is a density of the water or unit weight of the water, and H is a height of the tank, and D is a diameter, that divided by 2, that divided by 1000. T is a thickness which we are supposed to find, plus M minus 1 into AST. So here we know that WH by D, this is a hoop tension magnitude is 264 into 10 power 3, and that divided by 1000 T plus the value of M. M is a modular ratio that is given as 13, that minus 1 divided by area of steel, which is equal to 1.2. So here sigma ct is the permissible stress of the M25 grade concrete under tension. So if you work it out, we will get the thickness required to resist this magnitude of the hoop tension is almost 190 mm. So in the beginning we determined the thickness required, we determined the trial section, what is the trial thickness, what is required for the sidewall of the tank, that is about 170 mm. So this is not sufficient. So the required thickness to take care of the hoop tension is 190 mm. So this is a one way of checking whether the thickness is the thickness what we have provided is safe or not. And the other way, and in the other way what we can do is, so if we substitute the value of T here as, if we substitute the value of T here as the 170 mm, like what we had got from the relation what we considered previously, okay, if you substitute that value, then you will get the magnitude of the stress which is developing in the tank wall due to the hoop tension of magnitude 264 kilonewton. Okay, then from this you will get a certain magnitude of the tensile stress. So this tensile stress what you will get due to the hoop tension, this needs to be lesser than sigma ct. This needs to be lesser than sigma ct. So then only we can say that the thickness what we have considered is safe. Suppose if the magnitude of the stress what you are getting due to the hoop tension, if it is greater than the permissible stress value, then you need to revise the section. So this is how the section can be checked. Then once we got the proper thickness of the for the tank wall, then we can go for the further reinforcement calculation. Then the reinforcement in the tank wall, the spacing of the hoop that will be increased towards the top, because you know that the magnitude of the water pressure is maximum at the bottom. As we go upwards, the magnitude of the water pressure also will reduce, and also the magnitude of the hoop tension also will reduce. When the magnitude of the hoop tension reduces, the required amount of the steel will be less, then the spacing of the hoop steel also will get increased. So here what we can do is at top, because as we go to the top portion here, the magnitude of the water pressure, it's almost nil. So here in this portion, the steel is not required, steel itself is not necessary. So but we are supposed to provide a certain some minimum amount of the steel. Okay, so in such cases, we need to provide the minimum reinforcement. So here the minimum reinforcement for the a tank wall that will be 0.3% of the gross area or the cross section dimension. So 0.3% of B into D, where D is the thickness of the section and V is the unit dimension. So if you find AST, then so 0.3%, 0.3 by 100 multiplied by 1000 multiplied by thickness 190 mm, so we will get AST as 570 mm square. Then if we consider the same diameter of the steel, so normally why I am have taken a same diameter of the steel is it will be easy for the fabricator to it will be easy for a bar bender to prepare the reinforcement during the construction. So if we use a different diameter of the bar, even it may cause difficulty during the materials procurement. So the first we'll try to provide the same diameter of the bar by varying the spacing. If it is not possible, then if we didn't have any other ways, then we need to go for the other diameters. So in this case, I've taken a 20 mm dia bar, so I'll get the spacing of 550 mm. Then here, if you see the value of the spacing, it's almost 0.5 meter. And then we know that as per the codal provisions, we have a certain criteria while providing the spacing for the reinforcement. So we need to have some minimum spacing between the reinforcement in order to take care of the formation of the cracks. So in such criteria, we have the minimum spacing condition. So the minimum spacing, it should not be, it should not be greater than the 3 times the thickness of the wall. So here the thickness of the wall is 190 mm, so we take 3 times of 190, that will get 570. So the spacing, the what we provide, it should not be more than this value. But the spacing what we had got is 550 mm, so we can go for the spacing what we had got, that is the 20 mm diameter bar at 550 mm center to center at the top portion. Okay, then that is for the top 1 meter. See here, we have a 4 segments, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So we have a so the height of the tank, since it is 4 meter, we can divide it into the 4 segments. Okay, then for the first 1 meter, the amount of the steel what we got was 20 mm dia at 550 center to center. Okay, then next in the beginning only we had calculated the amount of the steel at the bottom, that is 20 mm dia at 118 mm center to center. So here we have got 20 at 118, and then when it comes, now we need to determine the AST which we are supposed to provide for this segment as well as this. So now we'll take will determine the value of hoop tension at the 3 meter for the segment 3, so which is located at a 2 meter below the top. So there which is located at a 2 meter below the top, so we'll find the value of hoop tension. We know that the relation for the hoop tension is WHT by 2, and to determine the value of AST you have the relation HT by the permissible stress of the steel under tension. So directly I had taken a relation for AST. So this WHD by 2 is a hoop tension and this is a permissible stress. So here when we substitute all the values, W is 10, H is 2 meter, H is from here, this is 2 meter, and the 12.6 is the diameter of a tank, that divided by 100 is the permissible stress. So if we work it out, we will get area of steel is equal to 1260 mm². So then to determine the spacing for the hoop tension, to determine the spacing for the hoop steel, so you know that you have a relation. So spacing that can be determined by the relation AST by AST. So as you know, a small AST that is represented by area of the individual bar, capital AST is a total area of the steel. So the area of 20 mm die bar is 314 and the total AST is 1260. So if we work it out, we'll get the spacing of 20 mm die bar as 250 mm center to center. So at 2 meter depth, that is for the segment 3, okay, so we need to provide a 20 mm dia bar at 250 mm center to center. Okay, then similarly we need to determine the value of AST at 3 meter depth. So I will just write the expression, I am not doing any calculation here. So for 3 meters everything will remain same, so W is 10 and then H will become 3, that multiplied by diameter is 12.6 divided by 2. This is the hoop tension divided by 100. So if you work it out, we'll get the value of AST. So take a same diameter for the reinforcement and then calculate the spacing. So here whatever the value we'll get, now the same thing will be provided for the, that thing will be provided for segment 2. Then so till now we had done the calculation for the horizontal reinforcement. So you know that in case of a circular water tank with the fixed base, okay, so sorry, circular water tank with the flexible base, as a reaction you will get only the hoop tension, okay. So for that reason, the main steel what we are providing in a circular water tank is a main reinforcement what we provide in case of circular water tank is the hoop steel. Okay, now so we just can't provide just a hoop steel for the tank. So we need to provide some steel to support that hoop steel. So to keep that hoop steel in a position, so So we need to provide a vertical reinforcement, and these hoop steels that has to be tied with the vertical reinforcement. Here the vertical reinforcement what we provide, it's just only as a support for the hoop steel. It doesn't meant to take any load. Okay, so for that reason we will be just providing the minimum amount of the steel. So that is equal to, you know that minimum amount of the steel for the water tank will take 0.3% of the gross area. So 0.3 by 100, thickness is 190 and unit dimension is 1000. So here the spacing of the 10 mm dia bar, so if we consider the 10 mm dia bar, if we find the spacing, we'll get 137 mm. You know that spacing can be determined by the relation area of the 10 mm dia bar, that is 78.5, that divided by area of total AC which we are supposed to provide, so per unit dimension, multiplied by 1000. So that will give 137 mm. So as a vertical reinforcement we can provide a 10 mm diameter at 135 mm center to center. Okay, the next component which we are supposed to design is, that is base slab or the tank floor slab. So here there is no any specific design for the base slab, because it doesn't carry any bending moment or anything. That means it doesn't carry any, it doesn't take any tensile stresses. So here, since there is no connectivity with the sidewall and a bottom slab, then so whatever the base slab is there, so that will get only the vertical water pressure. So everything will be under compression. So since so for that reason the nominal thickness is sufficient. So for that reason we are providing the nominal thickness of 150 mm, and then the minimum area of the steel we have to provide. So you know that minimum steel is equal to 0.3% of gross area. So 0.3% of 150 is the thickness and 1000 is the unit dimension. So we'll get 450 mm square in each direction. So here whatever the reinforcement we had got, it's the reinforcement required for the a complete section. So this needs to be divided on both the faces, that is on the inner face as well as the outer face in both the directions. So the half of the 450 is 225 mm square. Then if we find the spacing for 225 mm square by considering 8 mm dia bar, we'll get the spacing as 220 mm. Then we need to provide 8 mm dia bar at 200 mm center to center in both the directions on each face. So this is how the reinforcement detailing that has to be shown here. The reinforcement for the tank wall that has been provided in a single plane, suppose if the dimension of the tank is more, then it can be provided on both two faces, that is both on the outer face as well as the inner face. So here this is a sectional elevation. So the vertical line what is showing here, that is a vertical reinforcement that is of 10 dia at 135 mm center to center, and we had calculated the hoop steel at different segments. So here, so for the top 1 meter we are providing 20 mm dia steel at 550 mm center to center, and then bottom and then from 1 meter to 2 meter we are providing 20 mm dia at 250 mm center to center, and then for the remaining portion we can provide 20 mm dia at 180 mm center to center. And again here one more distribution we can make for 3 meter also. So in order to go for a more economical way, then you can find the hoop tension at this depth, then whatever the reinforcement will get for this particular depth, the same thing that can be distributed till for the third segment, that is at a depth from the 2 meter to 3 meter. So then when it comes to the connection, here the joint sealing bituminum compound has to be placed, so it acts as a bearing for the tank wall. Then this is how the base slab will be provided. So this completes the design of the circular water tank with the fixed base. Thank you.